February 15th, this meeting is being recorded for cablecast and YouTube presentation by Area 58 Community Access Media. The video of this recording is not to be considered an official public record. Alrighty, just to get it out of the way, did anybody have any amendments to the minutes? Okay, motion to accept the minutes as written.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Feel left out.
Alrighty, so let's.
Before.
Pass it over to you.
Before we turn it over to Zell, this is pretty much the last pass at the plans. This is it. This is what we're gonna run with. This is what's gonna be drafted and prettied up and explained to the townspeople. Want you to really look at it and agree with it and like it. And we want you to vote it so that we don't turn around. Does that mean it can change? Yes, it can change. After you've funded the project and we're in design development, we can tweak it a little bit. And of course, Zell has to come back with facades for this too. So I want you to know that it's not so final that you can't move a door or a room or increase something or decrease something, because you can. Right? But we're at that point where we really can't bat it around any further. And this is pretty much it.
I noticed it's smaller than last week's. Do you want to explain that to us?
Yeah, sure. Basically, after looking at some of the comments about moving some of the spaces around and really taking a hard look at what we feel are minimum requirements, I just try to be as efficient and compact as possible. And so it took a couple of hundred square feet out of it just by doing that. It wasn't really anything out of the ordinary. I was just trying to tighten things up, basically.
And you made changes that I had thought of, which was to get the door out of this room and put the assistant at the lobby.
So she would be the full-time supervision at the lobby.
Yeah, that lobby space is going to feel like a lobby space. A small lobby, but a lobby space.
Mm-hmm. I like that the showers for the locker rooms are more centralized. Is that way if we ever do need more, we can go out that back wall?
That's what we did. Basically, took your suggestion to put the lockers on the outside wall so we can expand if we ever have to.
And would the thinking be that if we needed to expand in the cell area, because that was another area where I know we cut back, we would just deal with something with the sally port and just kind of take that off?
Yeah, that would be more difficult to do. But certainly wouldn't exclude the idea of adding something to the sally port on the other side.
You could
always add in that direction.
Right.
Could you just put the cells over to the side and move the evidence?
Well, you could, yes, but then where are you moving the evidence?
That's what I think would be easier to add.
Yeah, you could. You're right. You could put the evidence outside. You could do certain
cells
things.
Yeah, that's.
But the issue with the cells is pretty much is that unless there's a real need for that,
that you're comfortable with too, and that given the way that we operate today and in the potential future as well, that it's unlikely we would need to be up at that 3 or 4.
Unless there's a revolution.
Well, truth of the matter is, if you needed two more cells, you'd take evidence out. Right. And add a room for evidence.
Right.
And you'd have two facing two with booking in between. That's probably what you'd do.
That's probably right.
Right?
Yeah. The only other thing that I thought of is there a divider between the toilet and the showers?
Yes. There's a wall.
It just seems like somebody needs to use the toilet.
These are single use. These are actually single use.
So if you have a couple guys in here they won't.
Oh. No. There'll be people maybe changing in their lockers, but the shower rooms are single use.
Right.
There's a men's.
But there's only one.
No, there's.
Correct.
Right.
There's just single use rooms. It's like a bathroom in your home.
It's sort of like it's like a dressing area and a bathroom. You think about it, you have multiple people using the lockers, but if you're going to actually use that, and if they really need to go to the bathroom, they'll use the staff toilet.
Right.
Yeah, but if they've disrobed, you know, then they have to go out to use the staff toilet while somebody else is showering, or they're...
Well, yeah.
They're okay with sharing the bathroom.
Well, this is actually the way things design has been going, as opposed to...
They don't have a shower now, they're going to be thrown.
No, it's actually a good question, because larger facilities that have bigger staffs would have a multi-use, would have a locker with a multi-use toilet, several toilets, and then several showers. Yes. But because the size of the facility and the program needs, we can get away with just using individual...
I don't recall Hampton had more than one.
I think I have Hampton here somewhere.
I think they have the same kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not looking for more than one. I'm just looking for a separation between the shower and the toilet so that two people can comfortably use them at the same time.
Well, actually, all we need to do is a curtain. Because, you know, if you really wanted to allow people to use the bathroom while someone's showering, it just put a curtain up or a door, I mean, a panel. Mm-hmm. It's not like we could make that happen. That's...
And then it may not be an issue.
No.
Hampton was a little bit different. It had a toilet room, mm-hmm, locker room, and then a shower room.
They separated.
That's more what I was thinking.
Right. The thing is, though, their plan was reversed. They put their toilets, as you know, on the outside wall, mm-hmm, and it gave them the opportunity. Well, it's just the way the plan was configured. Mm-hmm. We were trying to figure out how to get a smaller locker area for the women to work with the larger locker area for the men. So it's not like an even.
And this is another one of those things when we go to design development.
Oh yeah, we have to look at all.
Once we look at the structure of the building, the plumbing locations, the actual size of the fixtures, it's going to change.
Yeah,
little here, little there. You may look at it blown up and go, I love it. Or you may look at it and go, we're going to have to scrap it and do it over.
Yeah.
So,
let's hope.
But it's not catastrophic one way or the other.
No, that's why it's called design development.
We've done it. We've got the program in a building that Plympton can actually build and be proud of.
Chief, I know you had, in one of the designs, we had talked about adding another door. Do you have enough doors here now? Because you've got one for the Sally Port, one officer entry, and then one public. So you've got three doors, so that meets your need.
You don't feel as if you need one in the rear of the building?
Well, there's one crawl down the hill. Sally Port.
Okay.
Yeah, the thing about the rear of the building is that there's really nothing going to be going on there, because if you look at the site plan, the rear of the building is up against the tree line. I mean, they already have to cut back that tree line.
Yeah, and it's going to drop off, too.
And it's going to drop off right after that. So there's really nothing going to be going on in the back.
And that's some other generation.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not trying to...
It really is the back.
You're not going to outgrow this in 20 years.
Yeah, we don't want to put a whole pathway system along the back just to serve that door.
I just wanted to make sure. I figured that we had met it by adding the other doors.
So I have a question, if I could, through the board. We've gone from 6,600 square feet down to 62. Where did we lose the square footage?
Well, a couple of things. We, as you know, eliminated any bulk storage space. I mean, there is one storage area, which we assume you will be using for gear storage, sort of centered in the middle of the... But a lot of the other reductions are based on actually minimizing square footage. Mm-hmm. You know, it really got tightened up, and some of the original program in some of these spaces got cut.
Looks like
to squeeze it all down.
The locker rooms took the biggest.
Yeah, the locker rooms took a huge, huge hit.
I mean, maybe a little bit on the
meeting room took a big hit.
Did the lobby?
Yeah.
Quite a bit, it looks like.
So everything got kind of squeezed, and again, the effort was to see if to what point can you get some the actual functional aspects of it to work within, you know, and still meet program and still have, you know, a building that'll actually function. But again, when we all started this, the program requirements were the optimum, you know, for those spaces, but we couldn't make the optimum work. It was just too big and.
It's too expensive. It wasn't too big. It was the right size. You know, taxpayer can only afford so much. We're at that point.
So with the size of the public meeting room now, how many people do we think we're gonna get in there?
Well, I've shown here what I think is.
What do you think, 18?
I mean, those are.
That's 18 sitting.
That's, yeah.
With tables.
Basically.
If you take the tables out.
Five-foot folding table, two people.
I see, you take the tables out, you can.
And that's about what they had in, that's, you had the pictures I showed you last week. That's about what they had. It's about the same size as the one they had in Hampton.
So it's probably like.
Which, believe it or not, is bigger than it looks on the on paper.
Yep.
And when the tables fold up and stack.
Yeah.
He said he can get, I don't know, 30 people in there?
Yeah.
Which is.
One of the differences now is that we have eliminated the storage room. That was before shown always off of the meeting room for storing all the tables and chairs. But that doesn't mean that you know, we dedicated that space or some of that space to a public conference room, which is really, the idea of that space is to provide the chief and the staff a multi-use room that can be used for various functions that don't fall into any of the program categories. And so, I mean, that was with your approval.
Yep.
that we eliminated the storage for the folding tables and chairs.
Also, looks like there's an interior vestibule right below that, the old storage unit that went away too.
Yeah.
So it was just hallway space.
So there's, you know, there is some cutting of some of the program items to really keep this compact. And not only, it wasn't just a function of getting it to work in terms of still meeting the requirements of the program, but getting it on the site so that it actually would fit in that space. We really had to really, really keep it tight, because you don't, there's a limit to the flat, this flat's a little bit of a flat slope here.
Right.
It really, you know, once you get here, it drops off.
If you pull that building forward, you're gonna lose 8 spaces.
Well, you're gonna lose parking, that's right. So we've tried to tuck it in.
Push the building back a little.
Well, that's just it. The problem is the grade starts to slope off. And we're trying to put the building on the flattest part of this area. And
actually, I meant if we push it this way.
Oh, no, you're up against the property line.
Which
once,
it's supposed
that's
to close
different
on the 17th.
Oh,
so
really?
The same.
Oh,
yeah,
well,
but
we can shift it back, but that's.
Yeah, because, and I also, I'm concerned about the, you know, if we do need to build a fire station back there at some point, you know, we need egress for the fire department out too. But all that said, and I think this will make Dan very happy for me to say, we're where we need to be for town meeting.
Correct.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Yes,
we're actually
still
not.
Well.
Right, now let me explain.
Yep.
We're where we need to be design-wise, and this committee understands it.
Right.
We're not where we need to be with.
Oh, no, no.
Educating.
Oh, no, no.
Oh,
no, no, no.
Yeah,
no.
We know that.
Teaching.
Yeah, no. This was about
cons,
about what's on the paper.
Pretty pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. No, no, no. I fully understand. I'm saying,
okay,
from
all
what
right.
There's some tweaks that I think we would go through, but to your point, as you said many times, that's in the actual design phase,
yeah,
where we would say, well.
Well, this is the design phase.
But
the design development phase where you really start.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
The building really starts breathing.
Right. And you might tweak something here, tweak something there.
Where is the septic on this?
Well, there is no septic. I mean, there is a septic system, obviously, but it all is down at the DPW or whatever.
There's a pipe.
So there's piping that runs down. But that's one of the issues, and we raised it last time, is
yes,
that in this location, The current sewer, like, is right here, and it's gonna have to be moved.
You mean the current sedimentation box?
Yeah, the sedimentation box and then the pipe. It's not a big deal, just, they're gonna excavate it in this area anyway, so they'll just get pulled off, it'll be here or something, or some other place.
It can go under parking lot.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, oh, yeah.
It's probably better to put it there, because then you won't put something on top of it.
There's just the manholes that's...
Nobody's gonna dig through the parking lot.
That's right, it's probably, it's better.
Good point.
We'll have to buy a new one. It'll have to be H20 and, you know, all the strength necessary for...
As far as the site plan, we have, we think we have some space, a little breathing room, so we thought that it would be good to have some side paving along the, at the end, along the solid board, so you can pull up a cruiser next to, you know, so you have a little bit of space, you could have a couple of cruisers here and, you know...
You're gonna cut that, you're gonna take that out of your feet? Oh, you just drew it.
Yeah.
Okay.
For free. No, I realized when I laid out, you know, the actual size of the building, there is some space here, so it would be good to have...
That's a good idea. You don't want anything growing on the side of the building anyway.
Yeah, well, so...
So that's where we're at, and you notice we put in the entryway for the gentleman that aren't here that wanted to see that, and we'll deal with that as an alternate.
Yeah, I mean, it should be pretty easy to...
It's not gonna be easy, I think that's a hell of a drop.
Not enough for them to price it, that's from the document, I mean, there'll be, all the documents will have all the information, so... It's a steep, it'd be a steep drive, but...
How many cruisers do you have?
We've got six marked, two unmarked, one motorcycle, one ATV.
And your car, or is that part of the one?
That's part of it.
One of the unmarked.
They would all fit.
Plus the ATV and the motorcycle.
But those should be, theoretically, those should be in the sally port.
The motorcycle and ATV.
And there's room for that, there's room.
You'll be parking the cars in the four spaces to the left and public parking.
The ones that aren't on duty over here.
There's enough parking, there's enough parking.
In front of the sally port, which is closer to the building.
That's all we have.
You know, like I said, I think we've done whatever we can for this...
This piece of it, right. And then we can, if the land closes and we have the land, then when we go to the next side of this, that's when you would kind of tweak where you might be putting it and stuff like that.
Then we can look at...
Is that 17th of February or March?
March.
But for what we need to be able to say, we have a building that we can build within this match, this is notionally how it's gonna look.
More or less.
More or less, this is where it could be, it could fit on land that we know that we have. If we can move it a little bit.
We have to be certain and confident, because the naysayers are gonna wanna pick us apart.
But what I'm saying is, we're doing this within the tightest constraints possible, so we can do this. So if we have more land here and we can move it a little bit to make everything fit better, that's easier. But this, we can do it on the space, we can do it within the budget.
Really wanna try and get this thing bid as soon as possible.
Yep.
I hate to say that, but I wish we could...
It's always the case.
I wish we could keep going, you know, with the design, we just can't.
Well, hopefully we can, I mean, at the end of the design.
No, May, we're talking May.
Well, yeah, okay.
When is the earliest we could get a bid if it is approved at town meeting in May?
Probably looking at November, December bidding.
Yeah, fall.
Which is a good time to bid it, because most of the generals will be hungry and looking for work in the early spring.
So we would have a busy summer.
So we'd probably break ground in March.
Yeah, but we would have a busy summer to make sure we get all the stuff done.
Oh, yeah, you'd have a busy summer.
Because we won't have any money.
Believe it or not, the hardest part of the design is over.
Right.
Well...
Not for these guys.
No, the next phase, he and I, is terrible. I mean, we gotta go back and forth all summer long. We'll bring you in when we have to make decisions and give you progress updates, but you won't have to meet every other week all summer long. You'll be meeting once a month at best. You're not gonna sit here and go through 48 pages of half-done drawings.
Yeah.
You know, that'll confuse you. You wanna look at 48 pages that are nearly completed that you can redline. And, you know, so there's certain stages we'll bring you in so you can do your thing. You know, I want to make sure that he's got his right evidence boxes, his right gun boxes, all those type of things that, you know, to us, doesn't mean anything to him. It's life or death on how he operates his police station. That's the kind of stuff that we're gonna need help with. You know, utilities, planning board, board of health, that's all this committee when we start going to those boards. Because we have to go to the health board for a permit to modify a Title V system. We have to go to the planning board for site plan approval. I don't know if we have to go to the zoning board for use or not, probably not.
I don't see why we would.
Huh?
He doesn't get his basement, he's not gonna give us a permit.
Well, you need zoning if you have a basement, you don't need zoning if you don't.
So, how much does this cost? Square foot?
How much does it cost a square foot? I'll tell you what it's gonna cost a square foot. My opinion? It's gonna cost somewhere around $380.
$2 million building.
Oh, it's gonna be $2 million all day. All day.
That doesn't include site work?
It should.
Yeah.
The basic, it should include.
I think you're looking at like $2.2 for site work. That's just me. I mean, I think I gave a budget out last week.
Yeah.
I was pretty clear in what I wanted.
So are you reducing it from that budget though?
No.
Never reduce the budget.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, oh, was it? I hate it when my stuff's used in finance committee.
What do you think, we're just gonna pin it up?
I thought you were gonna pin it on the wall, we were gonna go away.
Burn it.
The ultimate, obviously, the ultimate estimate is the bid. And, you know, it's our job as we're going forward at the, you know, at the end of DD and at the end of, you know, 60% to do additional estimates to make sure we're not off the rails. Or the market's changed, or something has drastically changed that would cause us to have to go into a VE mode, which, you know, is value engineering, which is really devalue engineering. It's really taking things out. We don't want to get to that point. I don't think we're gonna have to if we can keep it as simple as we have.
Keep it simple and basic.
If we change it, like, if we change it to complication, it's gonna be a problem.
So the only other thing that I'm wondering about a little bit.
Yes.
And it's, so this is on, you know, at the conceptual.
Yeah.
Other drawings we've looked at in the past, and I think even one that you presented, gave us a change of the library parking lot, so just so that.
Oh.
You know, this is what we're really presenting, but this is what's in our mind for.
We had done that, you know, that conceptual expansion and changing of that reworking. I mean, we can, if you want to see that.
I think that.
I don't know if it's gonna be part of this job.
I think we're contractually, just on this little $60,000, $70,000 study. I think contractually we have to show a block where the buildings go, the fire department's going, and the site. I mean, that's how I remember we did the RFP. Not anything more than this.
Right.
But colored so that people can see phase A, phase B, phase C.
Well, yeah, no, that's fine. We had already started doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you showed the driveway for the library put over here.
Yeah, we have it. And we can certainly develop it further, but we have to come to some agreement about what it is you want to show. So, you know, this was, we had shown, this is when we had a big, this building being a large building.
Right.
In this,
Yeah.
But that's all, so that stops. But we can certainly
just
develop, we can develop this plan. I mean, we also had shown an enlarged
fire station.
Fire station, somewhat enlarged, just arbitrary, because we knew that anything you build is gonna have to be bigger than what's there.
Right.
Automatically. How bigger, how much bigger, we don't know.
We don't want to fight about that, but it's gonna be bigger.
And so the idea was to see how to max out the parking areas and how to have dedicated drives for each function. That was the other thing. Reconfiguring the library parking, so get it out of this space. So, I mean, we can certainly show this as a separate.
And
That's sufficient with this added.
Yeah, we will replace.
I agree.
Okay.
But Colin, again, we got to start thinking presentation.
Oh, no. We'll do some presentation drawings.
We're gonna stand up before town meeting and tell town meeting, Plympton can't afford a municipal campus.
Right.
But they can't afford to do step one, which is the police station. And here it is, bang. But this is what we envision 20 years from now. That's it.
Yeah.
But it's going to take the next generation to do the next piece.
This is one iteration of it, because we're not even, if we had, we don't know whether we can fix that building or we have to build new. We don't know that because it's never been studied.
No, but we do know the size that the building needs to be.
But we do know that, knowing what we know right now, that you could do something with the fire station where it is. You could put the police station in as being proposed, which is, that's all we're really coming for money for. You could do some other changes to help deal with the library, and you could do it all within the site that exists. We will now have that land, hopefully by end of March, but the point is we have to already be selling this. So we can, and that's probably one of the caveats, is that this may get reconfigured when we get to that point, but here you can see the work has been done. It can be done here. And we're really focusing on is the police station piece.
Okay. I have one question about that, and that is, in the future, if this lot becomes part of town property here, I mean, conceivably, the most practical approach to a new fire station would be to build the fire station and leave this in place.
Correct.
Back here, and then tear this down and make it parking, whatever.
And we had looked at some of that.
But that's going to involve more site work.
But the problem is you're playing right into the town meeting's hands if you do that, because.
But we're not talking about that.
You don't know what the final study of the fire station is.
Correct.
But we did what we were asked to do, which is show that the fire station, the police station, the town hall fit on the site. We can create accessways that are safe off of 58, and there's no more star land, right. You know, go-karts here.
And that's my point, is that we're doing it within the constraints that we have.
Right.
That could change in the future as we do the other things, but look, we have that here. This is where the police station goes. It can be built within budget, we believe. Yeah. And this is what we're presenting to you. And we're producing a police station that meets program needs for the police department and fits Plympton's, you know.
A nice conceptual drawing. Yeah, I mean, in 5 years, we're talking surrounding towns. You know, who knows if we'll even.
Yeah. We don't know, which is why we can't do more about that.
You may have a fire district with 8 towns. You never know.
Right.
I doubt it, because they're all territorial.
But just to be clear, I think that it should be presented as a site plan with everything as is, except for the changes with the new fire station, and a separate site
correct.
Plan showing
yes,
the new fire
absolutely.
Station and
yes,
everything else.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Okay.
All right.
I agree.
Now, that being said, the next steps would be for you to obviously harden this.
Yeah. Well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hardline it. Print it up.
Yeah.
Color it by zone. Whatever you're going to do.
Yeah.
Color up the site plan.
Yeah.
We're going to start on an information newsletter. And you could need it. All right? And we'll, if it's all right with the board, we'd like to lay out the draft with FAQs from the chief. You know, what happens to the gorilla cage? You know, stuff like that. You know, why do we need 2 cells? We only have 1 today. Those are the type of things that.
So.
We're going to sell the cells.
Take it up to Hanson, the scrapyard.
So,
per pound.
Let me just put the cage on in the town green and you can.
I was going to buy it when you declare a surplus from my spouse, but that's another story.
I just want the handcuffs.
I'm not going there.
Well, I talked to some friends just before I came up here, and I told them why I was coming here, and I've told them several times why I'm here, but, and I said, to plan a new police station, and one woman said, oh, that means our taxes are going to go up, and I said, no, we're trying to prevent that from happening, and there were 3 Plympton residents that heard me say that.
We need their help to get this building kilts.
Oh, yeah.
And it's conversations like that that start it, and we'll get them involved.
Do you have a senior center?
No.
Okay.
Hopefully in the old police station.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Historic building.
You can get grants for that.
CPS.
National Register eligible.
You can get, they don't give grants for police, but they will give a grant for a senior center. You know, a couple hundred thousand there. Executive Office of Development. That being said, I think that, you know, we do need to have public outreach meetings too, and I think we should be thinking about March being our road tour. I think you should give us 2 weeks to put together what we need to do for drafts, and we'll come back with some detail. You can have elevations by then too, right?
Yeah, certainly.
And then, maybe that would line us up for the April Saturday coffee at the library too. I mean, we should do some in the evening here with being able to, with a PowerPoint to show some of the stuff and.
Well, we should also present to the Board of Selectmen.
Why? What do they need to know?
Because they're liaisons.
Because they've tasked us to do this, and it's their thing, yeah. I think that's absolutely right.
I think we should meet with Selectmen, I think we should meet with the Finance Committee at some point. I'm quite confident if we did a library day, or we did a night or a day, you know, I don't think it would hurt to have a week before town meeting, to have a Saturday tour of the police station.
Oh, that would be great.
Because I think the average citizen would be quite horrified if they saw what the police station was. And I mean that, not because we want to do a project, because I was quite horrified when I did the walkthrough for the OPM.
Pancake breakfast.
We don't do that.
You feed the seniors, they'll be here. You eat hot dog, they'll be here.
If that's the case, I'll pay for the pancake.
Step it up to little eggs and bacon.
Yeah.
What time, when does the fire department have their pancake breakfast?
They already have it.
They already have it.
They've had it already?
They do it before Christmas.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay, so when do you want to meet next? March 1st, which is 2 weeks?
March 1st, work for you?
Which is 3 weeks?
I guess, yeah. I mean, I'll check with Jeff, but I'll see.
March 1st works for me.
My only issue is that I have negotiations 5:15, so that could go till 7.
I don't mind meeting at 7.
So if we can do 7, then I have a better chance of at least just being a little bit late.
Yep.
Can you make 7?
I'll make whatever I need to.
You know what?
He's all ours at this point.
You could be here on time if you weren't arguing over little stuff and just gave their raise.
I think she might have an issue, yeah. As with the selectman that's babysitting me, so.
So, all right, so the next one is 3-1 at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
But I would like it if you'd just vote to approve the plan as presented as a schematic, which is scheme, which means changeable. Root word of schematic is scheme. But I think it just shows that the committee has come to grips with the design and the location on the site.
Okay, so a motion to approve the schematic floor plan as presented and dated February 15th of 2017.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? And 3 abstentions.
And the record shows that the chief was behind it.
Yes.
Sounds good.
All right.
All right. We'll see you on the 1st.
Okay.
Motion to adjourn then?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved.